Hello everyone, Godot, surely you have heard about this game engine, but have not dared to try it? How so? I've been using Unity for so many years, all bloggers say, Unity, and this is some kind of unnecessary Godot?
Yes, that is exactly what I thought, until I decided to try it out myself and create my own clone of the popular Arkanoid game. But simply creating a game would be a bit boring, and I decided to hold a duel between two game engines, Unity and Godot. I will create two identical games on two different engines and summarize what was difficult and what was easy when creating games on these engines. I see no reason to continue this introductory speech. Let's move on to development. A very important part of creating a game is drawing graphics. You might ask, what is needed for Arkanoid? A ball, a rectangle and a platform, but I wouldn't be me if I hadn't done something to really great. That's how I drew the graphics for our future games. In the same way as in Unity, the first thing you need to do is create a project, and in the project folder, all the folders we need to store things, images, scripts and other things. If you don't even do that on Unity,
do it!
I moved our graphics to the folder with sprites and started creating a moving platform. It was pretty simple. To do this, I had to create a scene inside which I created an array 2D object. I can't say exactly why, but I know that it needs to be added. I added sprite and collision shape to the object we created. I set everything up and we already had a platform ready, which couldn't do anything yet. In order for us to move it, we will need to write a small script. Godot supports writing code in programming languages such as GDScript, C# and C++. Initially I planned to write code in C#, but then I changed my mind, since GDScript is almost no different from Python and I haven't made games on it yet. Right click on the player and create a new script. First of all, I declare two variables, on which is public and contains the speed of the platform, and the other is non-public and does not contain the speed of the platform. Next, I write a function that says, if the right button is pressed and our character does not touch the edge of the screen, that he moves. Similar to the situation with the left button. We also prescribe a function that stops our platform if you won't go to beyond the edge of the screen. And that is, now we have a moving platform. Folders for our project files have been created, graphics have been moved to them. What should we do next? Drag the image of our platform onto the screen. We adjust it to the desired size and add rigid body 2D, without which it's impossible to move the platform, as well as collider to be able to come into contact with other objects. We create a script, attach it to our platform, and go to edit it. I will not analyze the script in detail anymore, because it will take a lot of time, and we are all busy people here. Therefore, I will tell you briefly. I did the same thing as in Godot, only using more lines of code, since this is C#. The platform is ready, and as for me, its management is not different from the management of the platform created in Godot, to which I propose to return to create a flying ball and walls. A platform that can go beyond the edge of the screen is made, but it can still go beyond it. Why? All because I have not yet created a block that will be located at the edge of the screen and keep our platform in our visibility zone. Perhaps there is a way to do without the accelerated creation of walls, but I have not found it. In general, I create a new scene and add a new element there to which I set all parameters necessary to perform the functions of the walls. After that, I convert our scene to tile map and draw these walls on the main playing field. Now our platform will definitely not go beyond the edge of the screen, so the ball will also have something to start from. Speaking of the balloon, for him I also create a new scene, do everything the same as for the character and move on to writing code, which this time will be more. In Unity I also made walls, but transparent and it was a little easier than in Godot. Then he just moved our ball to the stage and involved it to the magical abilities, namely the ability to fly, break walls and break blocks, which are also not there yet. Blocks. Yes, definitely need to add blocks that will break when colliding with our ball. For them, we create another theme, quickly assemble the main components and write a couple of lines of code, after which we begin to place our bricks on the stage. Lo and behold, now it really looks like Arkanoid.
How are things going with Unity?
And everything is fine on Unity. I also added blocks, but just without creating a separate scene for them. I wrote a script and made a prefab out of it. After that, I began to play them on the stage, and oddly enough, everything works fine after the launch.
That's it! Two identical games on two different engines are ready. It may have seemed to you that it was harder to make a game on Godot, since I told you about it longer than about Unity, but in fact it's not. I just spent more time on this engine because Unity is more famous and you probably already seen how games are made on it. In Unity, it took me 2 hours to create the game, in Godot, 3, except for a few more hours spent on the internet searching for solutions to some problems. I can say with the confidence that Godot is a good engine, and Unity has been for a long time. And Unity was the best, it remains so. See you in the new video.